Welcome back, guys. Sorry, Taylor's going through a little bit of a difficult area. If the lion's up near Biffleshook boundary, then it's often quite tough there, the signal. So I'm sure we'll get back to her just now when she gets a stable signal. But we're still sitting with our giraffe in this beautiful area with the clouds. You can see they've got a bit of color on them. And then this water that's just reflecting everything. And these beautiful giraffes that are moving around underneath them. Isn't that a pretty scene? Absolutely stunning. And this little female giraffe is quite curious about us. She's coming quite close. Hello, girl. So, Crystal, you are wondering whether the giraffe have certain spots on them or different spots, depending on the individual. And indeed, they do. So each giraffe will have a very different coat. So much like our fingerprints, it's exactly the same. And look at that giraffe is salivating. So obviously the tree that it was eating was very tasty, or it's very hungry and it knows where a tasty morsel is. But it was salivating. There we go. You can see it dropping out, which is quite amazing. Clean up that mouth, my girl. But she's very curious. She's come very, very close to us and is just standing now in the middle of the road watching us. Hello, little one. So yes, their patterns are different. They have different spots and markings according to the individual and then according to the species. Now remember, here in South Africa we only see this species of giraffe. We only have the southern giraffe. But in other parts, and when we go to the Masai Mara in May, June, then you're going to see, we're going to see different species of giraffe up there. There's the Masai giraffe, there's the reticulated giraffe, there is varying other species that occur there. So we're going to see slightly different ones, and you'll see the differences in their coats. Their coats are going to be very different, so it'll be worth following and being able to then see the different coat patterns later in the year. Hello, girl. So you can see she's just come across to the side now and is starting to feed again. And again, she's onto one of the trees that a lot of animals will really struggle with. Giraffe are lucky. They have a long, long tongue. It's over 30 centimeters long, and it's kind of a blue-purple color. You can see it there. There it goes. Now, that coloration is like that because they have these rubbery growths all over their tongue, which lacks blood vessels and nerve. It means that they can feed off thorn trees without